Ambitious and motivated are words that describe you best. Then you're on the right place. This is Motivational Radio France from Paris with your host, Longi Agoha.
First of all, because I also have my own path with my finance, I was well paid, but I noticed just like most other professionals around me, I was spending and getting broke. I mean, before the end of the month, my salary was gone. And I keep wondering, where does this money go? So I never had answers to my questions. And so that got me searching. I needed answers. I wanted to be able to manage my finances much, much better than I was doing. I wanted to be able to, you know, have more in reserve. I wanted to be able to plan for the rainy day. I knew that, I was among the lucky few that was earning that as much I was earning then. So that got me searching for alternatives and searching for, you know, a way out. But I have mentors that graciously helped, you know, took me up and they brought me on this path. One of them is a famous financial expert in Nigeria by the name Adiolu Akin. That's one of my mentors. Because I have Obo the Great. You know, people that inspired me to look for answers. Of course, from there, I went through my own learning course, trying my hands on several things. I tried to start a network marketing company, failed at it. I've tried to do it by myself, failed at it. So I've been a bundle of failures, but I'm not a failure. But what happens? After a while, you get used to failing. And of course, it leaves you with a lot of scars, a lot of fun, a lot of experience. So I learned by failing and rising, trying and rising again. And of course, I've been mightily blessed by a number of financial books, especially the Fable of Rich Dad Poor Dad series. I've read quite a lot of them. I've also had opportunity to learn a close range from people who have worked in this sector. So that also, I learned firsthand from them. And then, I also have a big dream, which is, I've always dreamt about something that could help me, you know, reach more and more people. The job I was in wasn't giving me that opportunity. I was into IT infrastructure management as an engineer. And yeah, while I get the money, I wasn't having fun. So this gave me opportunity. This kind of gave me the motivation to make a career out of it. Go learn about finances. Go learn about financial intelligence. Go learn about something that could help you meet people and have fun seeing people's life change. So for me, it's both like being on steroids. I'm enjoying myself and I get paid to do that. You know, the other people that do that at footballers, they get paid to play football. And that's, for me, that's what it looks like. Okay. So all my life, I've desired to be in the position where I am today, which is helping people. And it is that desire to help people that made me become knowledge. And today, I thank God that I've come this far. Of course, is this where I want to be? Not at all. For me, this is only the beginning because I want to go very, very far.
So you want to end up becoming a financial guru? he laughs. Because that is arguably the ultimate, I guess.
I tell you what, I don't just want to become a financial guru. I want to be listed on Forbes. So that's when it will all come together. So I would tell people, don't do what I say. Just be like me.
Right. Follow your footsteps, okay? Now, that's great. It is wonderful. In fact, your story is more like my story because I have always believed in challenges. I've always believed in, you know, trying new things. And I've always had a dream. I've always had a dream of really helping people, you know, because that's where my passion is, helping the other person. So how would I find solution to somebody's problems? And so for me, it is my own area is in linguistics, languages, communication, and all of that. So that's where my passion is. And that's where I've been doing, you know, and I have fun doing it. I enjoy myself doing my job. I think one of the best things that can happen to anybody in this world is finding your passion and making your passion to pay you.
Exactly. You can't go wrong. Everybody has a passion. It's just that so many people have not discovered it. Find your passion. You have entered your power club. you can't go wrong. It takes a little more diligence and discipline, just like growth, to get the best out of it. So for me, that sums it up. Find your passion, find your dream, find what you could do effortlessly, what you could do and never get tired of doing. Find something that gives you joy, that, you know, takes you to on top of the world. Find something that you do and get and be fulfilled at the end of the day, that you have done something worthwhile. Find something that, you know, releases adrenaline and is part of energy in you. Find something that puts a smile on your face and the face of other people around you. Find something that you could live for, and if possible, die for, and then you will not be poor.
I really believe in that. I really believe in that. Let's move away into this passion thing, because I think this is one point that really brings all together. Passion. How did you discover your passion? How did you discover that?
It's a mixture of, like, say, frustration. And yeah, because I was frustrated myself. I knew I was good. Of course, I got so many awards when I was working. I knew I was good at my job. I was very hard working, but I wasn't having fun. I wasn't happy with my job, with my life. I always describe passion this way. Imagine buying a new toy, a toddler. The first day he sees that toy, he falls in love with that toy. That's passion. His face lights up, he carries it, and then he's not going to put it down. That's passion. Mm-hmm. Something that gets hold of you and you never let go. So, for me, I was frustrated because I wasn't having fun at work, but I needed to do what I had to do to make a living. And secondly, it's also because early enough in my life, I was exposed to a lot of motivational teaching, talks about, you know, aspiration. You know, so for me, also, there's an aspirational, you know, tangent to it. I was not prepared to live and be the best engineer that there was, because that wasn't my aspiration. Different aspiration. I needed to find something that fits, you know, into that aspiration. So for me, it's a mixture of being dissatisfied and looking for something that will deliver me out of my misery, and also a dream of something bigger than just earning a paycheck at the end of it.
I think that's it. Passion is a mixture of something you need to do or you want to do, even if for any reasons that you're not. They don't want to pay you. I guess if you're passionate enough, you would accept it for some time.
Yes. In fact, again, that's another dimension. Something that you are willing for free. I tell people, ultimately, if you are willing to do it for free, you throw yourself into it and you learn it so well that very soon people will be paying you to do it for them.
Exactly.
You can't do it for free forever. Eventually, you'll be so good at it that you will simply be too good.
This reminds me, I agree with you totally. This reminds me of something I always say. People who are excellent in their jobs, people who are experts or skillful in their jobs, these are people who found their passion early and followed it.
Yes. And I think we also, as parents, have a role to play here. Obviously, most of us want our children to become professionals and all that. But we must be careful that we do not kill their passion, their inbuilt, innate abilities, and the people God has put in them, you know, to make them great and to make them an answer to problems that are all around us. So it's instructive that some of us discovered ours early. Some people don't get to discover theirs until they are near to the grave. I always believe that the greatest treasures to be found are the cemetery at the graveyard. That's where dreams lie buried. That's where passions lie wasted. That's where great books that should have been written were never written and buried. That's where great songs, that's where great comedians, that's where, you know, great people lie having been very small. So passion is everything. Attitude is, you know, health to make it, keep it in check. And of course, vision, health, to take it far. So for me, I think it's always a plus to discover it early so that we can, you know, throw ourselves into it and give it all I think.
Yeah, I guess. I think failure starts from not discovering your passion. All right. So anybody, whatever you're doing, if you are passionate about it, I guess somehow you'll be paid handsomely for it. This podcast was brought to you by the Motivational Radio France with their host, Lanjago and Barris.